You're watching Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
Glad you're with us here for the opening night of the college football season. Marquise Williams, North Carolina, with a 13-10 lead in this border battle here at the half. Let's look at tonight's AT&T strong performance.
We've seen an overall pretty good first half for Marquise Williams. Struggled a little bit early with mechanics and footwork on this interception in the end zone, but as the game went on, he was doing a better job with his feet, getting them set underneath him, good weight transfer. We saw very accurate throws to the middle of the field to big 6'5" wide receiver Bug Howard. Right now, Marquise Williams, 10 of 13. He's also run the ball well. Been a good performance so far in the first half, minus that interception.
You know, and keep in mind the North Carolina defense last year gave up 39 points a game and nearly 500 yards per game.
And they still had some missed tackles. They still had some plays that they probably want to take back. But on the whole, just a lot more physical, especially on the line of scrimmage. They didn't get dominated in the line of scrimmage. They got to make some tackles. They got to tackle that guy, rushing the football.
Moments ago, Kaylee caught up with Coach Fedora.
Coach, what can you tell me about the conversation with Marquise Williams you two were just having?
We just had a lot of missed opportunities in the first half that, you know, we ought to be way up, actually, right now. And I'm really disappointed in the way the offense is executed, actually.
Physicality is the word Gene Chizik said he wanted to define this defense. Have you seen what you want to see on that end?
I think we've been physical all first half. I think we've given up a couple plays, three plays. We dropped a pick six. You know, so, but we're hanging in there, and that's what we need to do.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet.
No punts for Fedora's offense. Of course, stopped in the red zone on that opening drive of the game with the interception. And they're going to be right back out there to start this second half. HBC, sure anxious to get the ball back. He was mixing it up left and right with Mitch, Cooper, Wilds taking direct snaps. Now he will turn to his defense here for the second half in Charlotte. There's TJ Logan. Two career return touchdowns for Logan is Landon Ard set to get us going here in Charlotte in the second half. Season opener of college football 2015. Big boot all the way through. Maybe Ard should have attempted that long field goal at the end of the first half. Something always reveals itself early on in the season, early on in the game. What revealed itself to you so far?
Well, I think the defenses are improved. My question now in this game is which one plays the best in the second half. They were both bad a year ago, yeah. Both brought in new coordinators. They were both on their heels at times. I think the defense that plays the best wins this game in the second half.
How about you talking defense?
Yeah, no.
I like that. I like how you're kicking it off.
You're standing too close.
We talked about both defenses deciding the game because both of them were so bad a year ago, but I just think the physicality of the North Carolina defense has been good to see. So many missed tackles and missed opportunities a year ago.
Here's a swing on the motion from Switzer. Good thing they got him because he's dangerous in the open field. Sky Moore with a nice job defensively.
Yeah, Sky Moore has a lot of speed and good instincts going sideline to sideline. It's a good thing he made that tackle because it looked like North Carolina had blocks set up downfield. That could have been an explosive play.
Second and six. And Hood. Probably going to be just short of that line to make.
But that's what makes this offense annoying, is they swing it out and they throw it to Switzer on the sweeps out wide and the flip pass, and then they run it up the middle, and the quarterback can run it.
Hood this time had a stretch out because Sky Moore was wrapping him up behind the line of scrimmage. And then Hood.
Looks close.
See this mark here.
Sky Moore came up again to make another stop, third short.
And this is fourth down. And a quick snap. And he has to fight for second effort here.
Wow.
From their own 35 to open up the second half. This will depend on the spot.
Where that referee was running in to that pile, it looked like that was going to be a favorable spot for South Carolina based on his angle coming in.
Rolling the dice
on your own 35.
Early in the second half on your own 35.
It's going to be really close.
Remember that yellow line on official, but that's not. Referee Jeff Heaser.
I think Fedora's got a reason to be upset. If you show the replay, Marquise was stuffed initially, but watch his second effort. Watch, look, Skymore and company come in right there, but look at the second effort here to push forward.
I thought there, David.
But you can't see it.
Marquinhos Lewis, the JUCO transfer, did a good job collapsing his offensive tackle, and T.J. Gurley came up and made a big hit.
The runner was stopped short of the line of the game. That play is under further review.
So the ACC crew on the field says he was short of the line to make. And now Ben Oldham is our replay official. He's an SEC replay official. It'll be in his hands.
Watch Lewis here at the top, number eight, kind of slant in. He just makes the first contact. There's Gurley making the second.
And right there, he pushes forward.
And where's the football? Where's the football in relationship to the first down marker? In that pile, it's very, very hard to see.
Look at the line right. If they get to the line on the 35, so he's well behind it, and right there is where he starts to lean forward. Look at his left leg down.
It's just hard.
You're not overturning that.
Yeah, you need
There's
indisputable
no
video evidence. The ruling on the field was that he was short, and I'm just not sure from any of those angles how you can overturn that with absolute certainty. I'll tell you,
I would have wanted a measurement on third down because it was close on third down, too.
Here's another look. Well, I think this gives you probably the best angle, but you have to be able to see the ball, see the body, and you need that indisputable video evidence in order to overturn what the ruling on the field is, and that is that he came up short, and it's first down South Carolina.
If you put the two angles together, you can see Lewis is on top of him at the end of this play. Right there, he's on top of Williams. Right there. And if you do the other angle, you can see that it looks like Williams is over. Now look at, watch when Lewis is on top of him. After the second effort, he finishes and pushes forward right there. Now Lewis is on top of him, and he's across that line right there.
And you're sure by looking at that his knee hadn't touched yet or anything else. I mean, it's
not sure.
Well, that's why
it's like that. That's what's
that's
hard.
Why the default is always
that's
ruling
right.
on the field
that's
with
right.
the scenario that you just put forth.
But look, on third down, it was close enough to get a measurement. I would have asked for a measurement regardless.
And I think what they were trying to do was get up and snap it fast and
they
try
went quick
and
snap.
Catch him off a quick snap. But I think they would have been better off to get a marking after that third.
The ruling on the field stands.
That's a huge
ruling
stop.
On the field stands. So there was not the indisputable video evidence to reverse the call.
Talked about which defense played best in the second half. It's a very, very good stop. It should be a big confidence booster for number eight, Marquavius Lewis in the South Carolina D.
Now, to your point of indisputable video evidence, what they're saying is they can't confirm that the call is correct. They can't prove the call is wrong. So the play on the field stands, and it's a big one. A turnover on downs to start the second half. Rolling the dice from their own 35. Wilds stacked up, just a gain of one.
It's really important in the second half that North Carolina defensively, they have to get off the field, give the football back to their offense to let that tempo start and take over. South Carolina ran 41 plays in that first half. And so North Carolina, the scoreboard's good. I mean, you only gave up 10 points, that's awesome. But in order for your offense and Marquise Williams and this tempo to take over, you've got to get off the field. You've got to force some three and outs yourself.
Here's Wilds. And he is dragged down that time by Nakonde.
And it shows, I mean, it definitely shows a little bit of confidence in Larry Fedora going for it. And I don't mind it. I mean, I don't think it was a terrible decision. It is when you miss it, but it shows, hey, D, I got some confidence in you. You've done a great job so far limiting the damage. Right here is another opportunity. Who's going to get after the quarterback? A lot of these situations, Connor Mitch has tucked the ball and run. He's looking right to Farrell Cooper, and if he's not there, he's been tucking it down and trying to run for the first down. That's smart.
Kyle Markway, a true freshman tight end.
5-yard penalty, third down.
We've seen false starts. We've seen delay of games. There's a lot. We talked about all of the experience they lost from a season ago. A lot of new faces playing in their first games, but it's got to be cleaned up.
Ain't no preseason in college football.
No, there's
a lot
not.
Of the sloppiness often
it,
comes here.
It comes
game
in week one. You see it a lot happen on the offenses I played on.
And that's why there's a lot of scrimmages week one with teams. Teams don't want to play against good teams and get those
right.
mistakes out. They want to work them out against somebody they know they can
get that
dominate.
Ugly out of the way, Davey. Third and 12 now as they're backed up. And whistle blows again.
Prior to the snap, delay aim. Offense number six.
I've seen far
got
too much of that.
Third down.
From South Carolina as well. That's how they started the night.
It's not a noise issue. We're here at a neutral site. We're not playing at Georgia. You got to get the call in. You got to get it called. And if you're Connor Mitch, you can't try and be in the perfect play every time. Just get the ball snapped. Play football.
Here's Mitch. Looking for Cooper. Overthrew him to the outside as he was covered by Brian Walker, who has had that assignment much of the night.
Nice answer.
Great
by
answer.
North Carolina's defense. Obviously, you got a little help, had a couple penalties, but in a sudden change situation, you know, you pay off Larry Fedora's gamble. You don't get it deep in your own end. You put together a couple good downs in a row.
So Sean Kelly will come out after the back-to-back whistles and penalties, backed him up. And now Kelly, the puncher, comes on looking to just pin North Carolina. Hit the nose of the ball for the backward rotation here. And, oh, did he save it?
Wow.
What an athletic effort there. They're going to say it's a touchback.
It did.
Off the ricochet, he almost pulled it off. That was DJ Smith.
They're going to talk about probably where he touched it initially, too, because you can't throw it backwards. Remember, the ball goes over the plane.
Yes,
it's
the
not
ball.
The body.
It's not the
it's
body.
The ball over the line.
They're not cashing paychecks on Sundays here. Off the ricochet.
Touchback.
Yeah.
The ball
yeah.
replaced at the
20-yard
line.
It's unbelievable hands by DJ Smith. He catch that in the first place.
I think it was coming hot.
I think it surprised him even. Like right here, he's going, whoa, that's a football. Before he turns around and pitched it back. You know, obviously you'd like to catch that the first time on its way
easy
down.
Easy for you to say, Palmer.
Yeah, exactly.
South Carolina didn't cash in on the turnover of downs.
Nope.
13-10 Tar Heels. Davey, how do you see this review there?
Well, remember, the ball has to poach any part of the goal line. So if it goes across, and right there, if he'd have just dropped it backwards initially, it'd have been fine. But right there, you can see it's over the goal line.
And they have confirmed the call on the field.
Confirmed.
It will be a touchback.
Really confirmed.
Ben Oldham, our replay official tonight, he's had a little bit of work to do.
Been some sloppy plays in this game, hasn't it, Joe?
Been some curious moments in this game.
Yeah.
Some sloppy plays, some intriguing happenings. Had a return of a long field goal at the end of the first half. Fourth and one from your own 35, rolling the dice. Had a little bit of everything to start the season, Davey. Tyson Williams. As he gets his first carry of the game.
Still rotating those backs in there. They've had Logan Hood trying to find somebody I think they can give them a consistent ground game on those inside runs.
Williams stays in. He has opened a lot of eyes in fall camp. True freshman with 6 foot, 220 pounds. Play action. And he threw it behind Bug Howard, who is the lone man on the top side.
Talked about the up and down accuracy of Marquise Williams. You see him looking at Bug Howard. He didn't like the way the route was run, but off coverage gets cornerback Al Harris Jr. That's what you'd expect a senior quarterback with a junior wide receiver just play pinch and catch. Now another chance for South Carolina to get off the field early.
Third and six. They only bring four. Complete right in front of the sticks to the reliable Ryan Switzer.
It's a nice job of Switzer knowing where the first down marker is. How many times do you see receivers not get the right depth when it's third down? It's the guy that's been living in the slot early here in his career at North Carolina.
Williams downfield. That was well off the mark. As he had Davis finding coverage from T.J. Gurley.
That's really the first shot they've taken downfield. I mean, this offense has been dink and dunk, and it's worked effectively. That's why I think they got to continue to just tack. These corners keep backing off. They keep backing way off the wide receivers. Those quick slants have been open. Williams has either hit him or he's had a couple that were just behind him. They should communicate a little better.
To your point, it's Switzer who has the most targets. He's been targeted six times rather than more of the downfield threats. Set up the screen now. Nowhere to go that time as Williams was found by Jonathan Walton.
You're seeing this team speed that South Carolina has. And the strength of their defense coming into the season was a linebacker. But watch 28, Jonathan Walton run this way and follow a true freshman running back right out of the backfield. His reaction beats a block from the receiver, was able to make the play. Now, passing situation. Earlier we saw Kelsey Griffin at defensive tackle with a sack. Who can provide the pass rush for South Carolina? Keep number 12 in the pocket.
Third and long. Flag is down as Williams gets it complete that time to Matt Collins, but we will wait on the call.
It's a really nice pocket to throw from that time. The offensive
legal
line.
Formation. Number 71 right on the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty.
So
down.
They had five men in the backfield by not being lined up properly. And they tagged, I believe, John Heck.
Mistakes have been on both offenses. We've seen the false starts, the delay of games by South Carolina. All of a sudden now you got a junior right here, right tackle. 71. That's him up top.
That doesn't look like a legal formation.
It's hard to tell from that angle.
Negated a 14-yard gain. So now it's third and 15 after the penalty. Would have been a first down with momentum. Instead, still a hill to climb. Williams steps up. Downfield, open. And incomplete as Howard couldn't hang on after the big hit from Johnson.
We saw Johnson take a horrible angle earlier. It's a great job. Talk about knowing the weakness of your defense. A great job by your safety reacting to the outside. Look at him run and detach the ball from the wide receiver. It's a great job not doing helmet to helmet. Targeting, really used his hands more than anything.
And this is the first North Carolina punt.
Look at this formation
of the night. Non-traditional, they're breaking out of it now as they'll bring Corbin Daly back to the traditional 14-yard punt set, but they gave it a look at first. And here is Daly. As the fair catch is hauled in right around the 35-yard line. South Carolina defense stepped up just when they needed them. Isaiah Johnson, the transfer in from Kansas, making an impact.
Huh? ESPN College Football, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich.
Glad you're with us here in North Carolina, South Carolina, in Charlotte. You know, Columbia, South Carolina, actually closer to Charlotte than Chapel Hill, but both schools recruit so well here with the high school football scene here. They're going to take a shot. Connor Mitch downfield. What an effort, but he couldn't hold on to it. Samuel, are they saying that's complete?
That was not a catch.
That looked like it hit the ground on the top end when he brought it down.
See, to speed.
Debo Samuel, great
Debo
effort.
Debo Samuel, yeah. Looks like he has two hands on it there, but you've got to control the football.
How about the body adjustment, though, by the
freshman? Yeah, it was incredible.
The rest of the crew came in to correct the two officials downfield. Hard to believe they missed that with a ball rolling two revolutions on the ground.
But how about Steve Spurrier finally taking a shot? I mean, I'm starting to feel for the guy. Yeah, because, I mean, you know he's dying just to throw something downfield, which he wasn't able to do all the first half. Finally had a good look at it, and this is barely missed opportunity. A nice effort by Samuel. Just couldn't haul it in.
But it's also a message to Gene Chizik, too. You want to keep playing cover zero, keep blitzing us?
Yeah, we'll take
it. We're
going
to take a shot. And you have to do that. You have to back the defense out. So it's been nothing but dink and dunk all game. And now, look, we've seen this, too. We've seen communication problems and delay of games. And Connor Mitch is like, give me the play.
What a roller coaster ride for Connor Mitch. Started 0 for 5, then 5 for 5 with a touchdown. Now 0 for 6 since then. Second and 10. Swing Wiles. Ball is out. Who's got it? South Carolina.
That's twice.
Third down.
Think about how unfortunate North Carolina's been. They dropped a pick six earlier in the game. They had a fumble on a kickoff return from Samuel. They almost jumped on at the end of the half. Here's Brandon Wiles just not putting the football away. It's poor ball security. And luckily, Jarrell Adams is there to fall on that. Schottmer almost did. This could be a much different scoreboard right now. Had a couple of things work more fortuitously for North Carolina.
Larry Fedora said at the half, we should be up big.
Fortuitously, huh?
Third and five. Sprint near side. Throw it to the outside of Shamir Jeffrey.
Spurrier's unhappy on the sidelines because I don't think Shamir Jeffrey was the intended target on that play. They had Farrell Cooper in the slot running an out route trying to get to the sticks. And instead, Connor Mitch decided to throw it down the sidelines. Shamir Jeffrey wasn't even looking for the football. He was running that decoy runoff route. So again, some issues we're seeing in all different types of ways.
This is just like we talked about in the opening broadcast. This is going to be a defensive struggle. Two elite defenses.
Yeah.
This is what we talked about.
Yeah, two new defensive coordinators after struggling last year mightily. This guy's dangerous in the return game. Ryan Switzer, remember 2013, had 5 touchdown punt returns, an NCAA record for most in a season. Sean Kelly, not a good-looking punt, but it does take a good bounce. And then makes its way into the end zone. We got Saturday Night Football presented by Wells Fargo, Wisconsin, and Alabama. Yet another great part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. That's going to be Saturday at 8 on ABC. Folks, if you haven't been following the drama with the quarterback position in Tuscaloosa, it's still not officially Jake Coker. Alec Morris was getting first team reps. Cooper Bateman, who was playing wide receiver in spring ball, has been getting some reps. Who do you think it's going to be?
I'm going to go with Jake Coker.
I'm going with Bateman.
The most experience you've got, and at least Jake Coker, he is athletic. He's not as athletic as Bateman. Game one, big game.
Coker. Here's an athlete playing quarterback, Williams. Quick out to Bug Howard.
Bug Howard, how about the game he's had, guys? Career high already in receiving yards. He's done a lot of his damage in the middle of the field. He's been a guy that number 12 can get the football in his hands. He can make the first dude miss, making an explosive play.
21-yard touchdown reception earlier tonight. Good, hard running and well blocked for Elijah Hood. Check in with Kaylee.
Well, Tess, for all the records that Marquise Williams set a year ago, Larry Fedora said the big problem was he didn't know how to lead. He thought he just needed to be vocal with his guys all the time. After Bug Howard, frustrated after that last possession.
Elijah Hood. And Elijah Hood gave a little something extra. Isaiah Johnson made him a hood ornament. Big run.
They have to continue to do this, having success running inside the tackles. Could not do it a year ago. Here's an inside zone. Just good push and nice patience finding the crease by Elijah Hood.
Williams checks in to give Hood a break here. Screen game overthrown to Switzer. High and far to the left.
And that happened because Marquise Williams was frustrated because the ref didn't let him go as fast as he wanted to do. He gets frustrated, he throws his hands in the air, and he starts pouting. And then they snap the ball to him, and he misses Switzer. stay calm. Larry Fedora talked about it yesterday. When a good play happens, I want you to stay calm, stay relaxed. When a bad play happens, I want you to stay calm and relaxed. Stay consistent. You can't miss those kind of plays.
Good play happened moments ago, the 44-yard run by Hood. Will they get the glory end of it on this drive? Interception. Jordan Diggs comes up big. Missed opportunity again.
These defenses are trading right now, trading blows. This is just a bad read by Marquise Williams. He's trying to throw the slant to the outside, but he never accounts for the safety, who doesn't go anywhere. It looks like it's man-to-man off the snap. The safety stays in the passing lane.
Oh.
Marquise Williams threw it right into Jordan Diggs' stomach.
Watch Diggs step in, though. It looked like he's going to take the slant and then expand out when he sees the ball. That's a heck of a play. It looked like he was taking Hollins on the slant, but then breaks back out by reading the quarterback's eyes. Good vision.
David Williams, direct snap. And he's only able to get a couple of yards as there was a big hit that time by Stewart and Schopper.
Aggressive play of North Carolina defensively now, flying up to the line of scrimmage. You know, one thing, when I watched practice from North Carolina a couple weeks ago, watching Gene Chizik, he's so positive with his guys. He's hands-on, he's very detail-oriented, but extremely glass-half-full.
They needed that.
Because their defense was one of the worst in ACC history a year ago. I really think his positive approach is going to have such an impact on his side of the ball this year.
And now it's Pharaoh Cooper lining up behind center to take the snap. He goes from Williams to Cooper. Second and eight. Cooper dropping back to pass. Why not?
That's why not.
Starting quarterback didn't complete the deep ones either.
No, that's true. We talked about it earlier, though. They have a full package for Cooper. And that one looked right there like he just wanted to throw a post. I mean,
that was triple coverage, by the
way.
Yeah,
he was just throwing it up.
He's still letting it go, though.
But listen, they run the counter. They run the power. They run passes with him to keep defenses off balance. But I think that will get him out of the quarterback spot pretty quickly.
Yeah, and Connor Mitch now back in that spot. Third and long, not where they want to be. You're anticipating this football going to number 11. Pharaoh Cooper is lined up in the slot, right down in here.
Here's Mitch. Wide open and complete to Terry Guger.
How about that design by Steve Spurrier? That time using Pharaoh Cooper almost as a decoy to open up a route coming in from behind him. Pharaoh Cooper ran the hitch route to try and suck up defenders to him, and that opened up a giant passing lane behind for Connor Mitch to throw into.
17-yard reception, third and eight. Now on the ground, as Williams looks for something, and makes his way to the 42.
South Carolina gives a little tempo on that one. They've ran a lot of plays. Had a lot of success running the football. North Carolina, they're playing some more guys than they were a year ago up front, but they want to use those body blows too. Jesse, the way they've ran the football, I'd keep running.
Yeah, me
from
too.
South Carolina, I'd just keep pounding the football.
And they've been creative. And you can do it with Wilds and Williams and Cooper. You can do it with Mitch. There's a lot of different ways they've done it. Right now, going back to the Wildcat again with Cooper.
Cooper comes back to take the snap as Mitch comes to the near side. He's going to pass. He was looking for his quarterback. Now he has to make the most of it. Trying to outrun the defender, and he does, and gets the first down.
What a fantastic effort that time. And a good decision not to throw that football to Connor Mitch down the
side. And a great play by Des Lawrence. He's the corner into the boundary down there. He was coming up to make the tackle, and then he sees Connor Mitch running down the field, and he adjusts late. But then Cooper, I mean, that's what he does.
So he was limping coming off the field
like
after
playing
that run. Yeah, you wonder if that's cramp or you wonder if that's knee, but I mean, he ran about 80 yards on that one play.
You play touch football in an elevator with him and lose.
So a first down at midfield. And Mitch loses a yard that time as Drennan was waiting on.
So key if you're the Tar Heels defensively. If you're going to lose this game, lose because of Connor Mitch throwing. Do not, you got to take the run away and make Connor Mitch win or lose this game in his first start. That's huge to get those types of plays on first down and put him in these precarious situations. that he won't feel comfortable in.
Look at the time he has on second and 11. Back released and then complete downfield again to Guger.
How about that? That made too many great throws down the field. No Farrell Cooper at all. Does a great job buying time, getting outside the pocket, throwing a strike. Now Cooper's hurt.
Flag is down at the 43-yard line.
Receivers are dropping. Cooper came back in.
Hot and humid night.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct against number 6 for taunting. 15 yards, first down.
They're going to march it back against the quarterback for taunting.
Wow. You know,
how many times do you see that?
You don't. And
first start under Spurrier and you get a taunting call?
And Connor Mitch is trying to plead his case to Spurrier and his quarterback coach, G.A. Magnus. You talk about, you know, playing in your first start and, you know, trying to control your own emotions, and you haven't had a ton of success, but you make one of your best plays of the game.
Jess, what's that going to look like Sunday and Monday in the quarterback room? What's that conversation going to be like?
It'll be very short. You're not going to say, you might say, I'm sorry, and then you move on.
So the first down was made, but now the ball is spotted back at the 44. Mitch scrambling and taken down. That was a good effort that time by Thomason and Hart.
And North Carolina hasn't brought, they haven't got a lot of pressure on him at all. But I like that by him, too. I know he got lost a yard, but tuck it down. Don't make him throw into a bad place. You just got a 15-yard penalty. Live to fight another day. Otherwise, you won't be playing. Spurrier, pull the hook like he used to do with Jesse.
He's done with everybody.
Very often.
Tackle for loss leaves him at a second and 12. Mitch escapes that and then sends it out.
You got to finish the play, though, if you're North Carolina. And I know a lot of people, you know, look at Mikey Bard, you have an opportunity. That's one thing I saw on film last year as well. They only had 17 sacks. One of the reasons, they had a lot of chances to bring guys down in the backfield, quarterbacks. They weren't able to finish plays. Even just a play like that, that's an opportunity. You're looking at a 7-8 yard loss. It changes field position. Force potentially South Carolina to have to punt to arguably the most dangerous punt returner in the country. It's a missed opportunity. It's great to have third and long, but it could have been worse if you're North Carolina.
Third and 12 now. Mitch, good max protection here for him as he's looking it over. And he took just a little too long, like forever. DeJuan Drennan and Jesse Rogers.
Finished that with Palmer.
Well, he's lucky he held on to that
yes,
football.
Yes, he did.
He started palming the football in his left hand. But, again, you know, nothing's open downfield. It's a two-man route. Just go get what you can get if you're Connor Mitch and trying to help out your punter. Again, this is not what you want. You never want number 3, Ryan Switzer, back returning punts for North Carolina. This guy is a breath away from taking this to the house and setting the place on fire.
See if Sean Kelly offers it up to him. Flag comes in again.
Yep.
Ball start, offense, number 4.
I think you can officially put tonight into the sloppy box.
Yeah, and it's week one. It's not shocking.
Right. This is what you see sometimes.
Yeah, sloppy box, huh?
Yeah. I've been going in the wrong direction here. This drive had promise to it. And then they hit reverse. Switzer lets it bounce. Carolina's got a chance to pin him, and they do. Field position battle won by the Gamecocks. Still 13-10 here in Charlotte. Still to come tonight, it'll be TCU and Minnesota. Big opening night of college football. Horned Frogs and Gary Patterson, national title contenders, finished up last season so strong. Javon Boykin and that offense absolutely loaded. That'll be the nightcap here on ESPN. For now, we got a tight one here in Charlotte. And And North Carolina needs to get out of trouble, holding on to that three-point lead. From their own three-yard line, Hood breaks free again. Just what they needed, Elijah Hood. Churning and burning. Local kid from Charlotte Catholic High.
Last year's offense of style didn't suit number 34 because it was all east-west. This guy's 220, built to go downhill. See, there's an opportunity to make a tackle by Sky Moore in the backfield, and just too much power. Lake drive by Hood.
Here's Hood trying to turn the corner and helped by a decent block from Spain.
He can squat 605 pounds, guys. I mean, this is a guy that you want running in between the tackles. Originally was the seventh ranked running back coming out of high school, committed to Notre Dame, changed his mind to come back home in state. He can be a force in this offense.
Snap infraction.
Center.
Against the offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
You don't see that very often.
Elijah Hood now with his first career 100-yard game, and that 21-yard run. Now, listen, he had a 44-yarder earlier, but that 21-yarder, you're pinned at your 3-yard line in a game that's tight and is choppy. That was huge.
I put him back in the game and run it up the middle some more. Last couple drives, he got himself in trouble when Marquise Williams is throwing the football and making mistakes. Running game's been actually working and picking up for him.
Williams quickly to Bug Howard. T.J. Logan is in at running back.
South Carolina subbing all the defensive line, trying to get a pass for us. Bring back in Marquavius Lewis.
It's a name we haven't called enough to
only
the liking.
Once on the QB sneak.
Of John Hope, the new defensive coordinator. Third and three. They're going to pass. Williams. Finally, they find him, and it was Kelsey Griffin. He had a nice play earlier tonight and comes up big here as well.
First sack earlier in the night was all him with a quick swim move. This one right here, you got to give a lot of credit to the secondary for South Carolina. Nobody was open. Marquise Williams had nowhere to go with the football. Great job by Griffin running him down. Let's still count, big fella.
Fourth quarter awaits. Tight one here in Charlotte. Which way will it go? South Carolina defense stepped up when they needed to. I wanna taste love and pain. Wanna feel pride and shame. Boys, we got a live camera down there at the Hickory Tavern in Columbia. They got some good throw at the Hickory Tavern. Having a good night.
We got Columbia covered, huh?
Hoping they're watching Gamecocks rally here as North Carolina. Corbin Daly on to punt. And Cooper calls for the fair catch just over the 35-yard line. Well, we want you on the lookout for the Taco Bell student sections, passionate fans all season long. You can go to ESPN.com/Taco Bell and learn how to win a chance to join your school student section at the College Football Playoff. In with Kaylee. What's going on with the wide receiver front with the Gamecocks?
Well, Tess, as Connor Mitch looks for targets here, Debo Samuels will not be an option. He's got a hamstring injury. He will not return to this game.
Redshirt freshman Debo Samuel, who they were expecting to play a larger role in the offense, he is out of action. Keep it on the ground this time. David Williams tackled by Jones.
So without Debo Samuel on the field now, number 8, Shamir Jeffrey, who's in his fifth year, younger brother of Alshon Jeffrey, comes in the game. And in his fifth year, they're waiting for him. They've been waiting for him to really step up and make an impact. And now he's going to get a lot of playing time here in this fourth quarter. He may be counted on to make some plays.
He has 8 career catches.
Yeah.
Big Bro had 183.
Yeah. Big Bro's about to make a lot of money, too.
Oh, yeah. Lack of experience behind Cooper at the receiver position. They go with the tight end screen that time. A lot of traffic for Jarrell Adams as Donnie Miles tackled.
Worked earlier. Early in the game, remember, that was one of the best plays to get this offense jump-started. But North Carolina did a great job taking care of the short stuff, the quick screens and the wide plays. I mean, they're up in the face of the receivers right now. That's why you've seen South Carolina take some shots deep.
Third and three.
Looked like North Carolina was showing pressure. Hunter Mitch looked to the sideline to potentially change the play. The cat and mouse.
Williams was untouched until he got to midfield. And then finally it was Collins who wrapped him up, but it's a first down for South Carolina.
And it was a good counter because North Carolina is going to bring the blitz from this side. So they run it away from the blitz where there's a defensive end dropping back into his zone coverage. It's a soft line and a soft edge. Nice job there using kind of the hurry up fake count, trying to get North Carolina to show their hand.
Set of downs now for Mitch. Sean Carson gets a carry, and Carson can go. Watch out! Sean Carson, a senior who averages 7.8 yards per carry. He just went for 48 and a score. Columbia at the Hickory Tavern. They're roaring. Fry makes it 17-13. How quickly things can change.
Lots of different ball carriers running the football for South Carolina, whether it's been Wilds, Williams, Farrell Cooper, Connor Mitch, now Sean Carson. We got the change of pace back in. South Carolina taking the lead.
One of the Heisman hopefuls is coming up on our doubleheader to open up this season. TCU's Trevon Boykin will be in action against Minnesota when we get finished here in Charlotte. Joe Tessitore, Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, and Kaylee Hartung with you. South Carolina just took their first lead of the night on a 48-yard touchdown run from Sean Carson.
Last play was perfect. Watch South Carolina. They draw. Watch North Carolina. They catch him in a stunt right here. And you'll see that when they run the play. First of all, they got their speedster. Carson is probably their fastest back. Look at that play. The angles work out perfect. The safeties come up. Look at the blocking by number 17, Carlton Hurd, on the outside. They caught him in the perfect defense. And they got the ball to their speedster.
It's the second time on that series they did. Remember that third down earlier? They got them to show their hand on that blitz and ran it away to keep the drive alive.
How does North Carolina answer? They go back to Elijah Hood, who's had a big game. Here's what happened, though. While everybody's celebrating the touchdown, Connor Mitch was brought in by the training staff to the locker room. So we will find out what's going on with the starting quarterback as Hood is stacked up by Cedric Cooper.
This is a very different looking South Carolina defense from a year ago. Energy, swarming to the football, assignment football in the second half, night and day. I think you got to give John Hope, the new defensive coordinator, a lot of credit. They're playing with a lot of energy against what was a record-setting offense at North Carolina a year ago.
Third and six. They're 3 for 9 on third down conversions. Williams with time. Incomplete. And Williams is down. Took a shot on a nice follow through.
It's just good push and setting up a net by South Carolina's defensive line. No extra pressure, just four guys up front. It was finally Marquavius Lewis who broke through.
He elbowed him.
Yeah.
Got him with the elbow.
Lewis is the JUCO transfer who was on everybody's wish list. He's one of the very top JUCOs in the country. Now he's lining up for South Carolina. And the dangerous Pharaoh Cooper back deep for Corbin Daly's punt. Bad snap. Daly did get rid of it, and it's an ugly one. Uncle Mo is with the HBC. South Carolina's got some momentum now. Both quarterbacks have taken their hits. Williams felt it moments ago, and Mitch was trotting off the field.
ESPN College Football, brought to you by Buick, proud partner of the NCAA, and Dr. Pepper and College Football. It's a one-of-a-kind tradition.
South Carolina has won two straight in five of the last six meetings of this series. And now they have the ball back after just a 17-yard punt. And Sean Carson's at it again. I wanted to show you what happened with Connor Mitch. This is two drives ago. He took a big hit, Jesse.
Huge hit from Drennan. Should have just run that football out of bounds. That was a massive shot. Still surprised he did not fumble that. That's what led to him going in to the locker room.
So Perry Orth out there again. We saw him earlier tonight. And Carson remains the running back. They are deep at running back. And Carson, well blocked and good running from Sean Carson.
Great patience.
Kelly, what's going on with Connor Mitch?
Well, Joe, you guys saw the play. After that, trainers first started looking at his left hip, let him play another drive, and then took him back to the locker room.
Got another player down on the field right now. It's defensive tackle Tyler Powell, very slow to get up. You know, South Carolina, regardless of who's playing quarterback or who's playing running back or getting the carries, they're having success with that outside run play to the right side of the offensive line, pulling extra bodies and extra linemen. That's where they've had their most success in the last two drives.
You know what's coming your way Monday. We finally find out who's the starting quarterback for Ohio State. Urban knows. We got to know. College Football Primetime presented by Capital One, Ohio State, Virginia Tech, Monday at 8 o'clock on ESPN. Of course, watch ESPN. Any screen you've got, starting now through Monday night, watch ESPN will deliver college football to you. You're in Urban's shoes. Who are you giving the ball to go out there?
I think, again, can't make a wrong decision. Both guys can make the playoffs.
Lambeau, which one are you going to
drive? I'm going to take Cardale.
Why?
Because I think he has a skill set at 6'6", 250 that you simply can't coach. The ceiling's higher. I think in this particular game, against that style of defense that's going to pressure you, then Cardale Jones gives you the best chance to win on the road, in my opinion.
I take JT Barrett in that game because I want a better distributor. And he also saw Bud Foster last year and got experience against that defense. He'll be more ready for it.
They fake the reverse, and Carson lowers the shoulder after a game of two. Perry Orth in at quarterback, the former walk-on in for Connor Mitch.
How big would it be for South Carolina to put up seven right here? Starting quarterback out of the game, with your defense playing as well as they are. Make North Carolina pay that last punt.
17 yards.
They had an issue just fielding the punt, and they gave you a gift back in their own end. You can capitalize right now, bleed some clock. That is the best scenario for the Gamecocks.
Worth checks over on second and eight. Clock counting down towards the 10-minute mark here in this fourth quarter. He's going to keep it. And Orth dives ahead. That'll be a first down.
And it's tough when the offense gets going and the running backs start having success. You watch the defensive end come off the edge right here. You think about the running back. That's all you're thinking about. And continue to run to the right. We talked about Shell being on the left side. They found something running to the right side. South Carolina keeps doing it over and over.
See where they gave him this mark here, because now they're going to call for a measurement. But he went head first.
So he gets all the yardage.
Normally, first, just short.
I mean, by an inch.
He put his hand up to confuse you right there. Yeah. I thought he was putting it up to bring it forward.
Yeah, I got totally confused.
Well, we've seen North Carolina get stuffed on a QB sneak on their own 35 to start the half.
Judging by the way, though, you know, I think South Carolina's offensive line, I think, is surging better right now. And again, I mean, you could sneak this. And if I was to do anything short yardage right here, I'd be looking behind number 71, our left tackle. Big guy right over here.
So Gene Chizik thinking about this defensively.
In the shotgun.
Desperate need of a stop. Williams, that was a good push.
Stopped.
And a nice effort from Clark. And you saw Rashad come in as well. Good work up front. Brandon, for that Tar Heels defense.
Now Brandon Wilds comes in. He's your biggest, most physical back for South Carolina. 6'2", 220 pounds. Steve Spurrier here using as much clock as possible.
Hey, under center.
Fourth and inches. Quarterback sneak. I don't think so, guys. That was Jeff Schottmer, the senior leader of this defense, who came in strong against Perry Orth. Gene Chizik waiting for this spot.
How impressive. What a surge.
Turnover on downs.
Wow. Front seven from North Carolina. This is a defensive war in the second half.
Each team with a fourth and short stop. This time, Schottmer, big time. Been a coach that's accomplished more in building up a program in the last 15 years. Gary Patterson, number two TCU, will be taking on Minnesota on this doubleheader of opening night of college football. Glad you're with us here. Joe Tessitore, Jesse Palmer, David Pollock, and Kaylee Hartung. After a fourth down stop by Gene Chizik's North Carolina defense, now opportunity again for the Tar Heels, trailing by four. Showing pressure off the edge is South Carolina. Williams. Not much on the short side. Well, moments ago, Steve Spurrier, fourth and short. Stop. Didn't kick the short field goal with a very reliable, productive kicker to take a 7-point lead. Instead, this is what we're left with.
Yeah, easy to say now, but a bad decision. And I understand the offensive line had been surging very well here in the second half, but you got an opportunity to make it a 7-point game.
With your defense playing great.
Yeah, I think you have to do it.
Williams on second and 12. From the 1-yard line, gets it complete to Howard, who fights for extra effort to try to get that line. Bud Howard's had a big, big night.
Yeah, he's been the comfort zone for Marquise Williams on the outside of the field, particularly throwing to his left. Because of the tempo UNC plays at, the outside receivers don't flip-flop, so you know 84 is always going to be to the left side, and that's why Marquise Williams has had the most success tonight.
Pressure on first down, was able to get rid of it, and complete. While he's being pulled by the jersey, gets it complete for a first down. Good job by Davis.
And that's you can't coach that. And we talked about Marquise Williams. Watch Walton coming off the ends. He just steps up. That's a 235-pound man hanging on to him, and he still delivers the strike.
Now Logan spins free and picks up 8 yards.
It's good to see if you're the Tar Heels. This year, Marquise Williams cannot be your leading rusher. You got to be way more conventional running the football, and already tonight we've seen these running backs having so much more success. Almost 200 rushing yards already for the Tar Heels, and a lot of that has come from the backs, and that's how it needs to be.
Defense had the fourth down stop. Now their offense is trying to take advantage. Good looking drive so far. Just over 7 minutes to play. Trailing by four.
False start. Offense 71. 5 yard penalty. Second down.
They've been spreading them around up front. Caleb Peterson had one. Heck had one.
Remember, Heck also technically lined up in the backfield on that one play, they said. And so, again, sloppy play, a lot of just self-inflicted wounds pre-snap from a very inexperienced offense from South Carolina. And what's making Larry Fedora crazy, it's happening to his very experienced offense.
Second and seven now. Receivers 2 by 2 here as Williams will pass. Quick out, caught. Looks like he may be just short of that as Holland's body momentum took him out. Third and very short.
Hadn't been good for either team lately, has it?
No, it hasn't.
Both teams have had turnover on downs.
Elijah Hood comes in the game for North Carolina.
And South Carolina is huge in the middle of their defensive line. They've got three defensive tackles that weigh more than 315 pounds.
There's third and less than a yard. And Hood gets loose again. Look at Elijah Hood keeping his balance. What a talent this kid is.
And they talked about him in camp. They said he loves full pads. He wants full pads. He's the most physical guy on the team. Watch him keep his pads north and south. Look at him. Stay square, keep his feet moving, and running hard.
Williams now gonna take a shot. But it was beyond the reach of Ryan Switzer. But that 29-yard run by Elijah Hood. They're in prime position now.
And he just looks so much better when he's going downhill. He gets some steam running north-south. They've got a lot of different weapons and a lot of different guys, but I think 34 needs to be the feature guy all season long, toting the rock in North Carolina.
Remember, Marquise Williams turned to us yesterday. We said, who's the most improved player on your team? Didn't even hesitate, Elijah Hood. Second and 10. Didn't put it away. Wasn't the cleanest, but he couldn't corral it.
Mr. Reliable, all game long. Fans can't believe it. I'm sure Marquise Williams can't believe it. Bug Howard can't believe it. That was a good pocket to throw from. That was just easy. Now you got the third and long situation. Marquavius Lewis, some of the best pass rushers from South Carolina, now back on the field in a mass substitution. Looking for that pass rush that they were missing so bad last year.
Third and 10. Little bubble, Switzer. He's got room inside the 10. They ran the little guy on a bubble. They blocked in front, and he did it.
And South Carolina's packing everybody inside. You see it in the replay. They got all the bodies. Right in here on the inside of the line of scrimmage, look outside. It's 3-on-2. Simple math. They're going to take that every single time for North Carolina. South Carolina has to adjust on the outside.
Logan now taken down after a yard and a half. 14 yards on that screen on 3rd and 10. That was clutch.
How do you not get 34 in the game down here near the goal line, too?
Big body running hard downfield all night long. Elijah Hood.
Now subbing in Romar Morris, number 21 at running back, who they like to throw the football to out of the backfield. It's kind of that tweener at that position, very versatile. The anticipating pass here if you're South Carolina.
Second and goal. Williams gonna try to do it himself. Little help from his friends inside the 5 yard line. It'll be 3rd and goal from about the 3.5.
So much to think about and worry about now for South Carolina defensively, because there's so much you have to defend. You've got a big running back in Elijah Hood that can come in the game. You've got a running quarterback in Marquise Williams that had 13 touchdowns a year ago. You've got 3 wide receivers that are 6'4" or taller, so you got to potentially defend the jump ball. What do you do if you're John Hoke, defensive coordinator at South Carolina, in this critical down and distance?
And it's tough because I think it's 2 down territory. This late in the game, you're probably going to go for it regardless. So that's why I think you anticipate run here. Marquise was the short yardage back all last year. Now he's the quarterback.
Williams to pass. He can't get rid of it. Slammed down near the 10-yard line that time by Dante Sawyer. The two new kids on the block, Sawyer and Lewis, getting after Williams.
This changes your thought process. I think you got to kick it now.
They're going to talk it over. 3:40 left, and you say cut it to one, Davey, after moments ago you felt it was two down?
Yeah, when you're on the 3-yard line. Now you shoot yourself in the foot. Elijah Hood's toting rock, Marquise Williams toting rock, and you decide to throw the football.
We'll see what they come up with when we return. TCU Minnesota's coming up. We've got fourth and goal here. North Carolina trailing by four. Fourth and goal from the 8. 3:40 to play in the game. Winshot Davis is the receiver. All alone on the top.
Last time they hit Switzer down low in the 7-zone formation.
He's closest to him. Williams extends the play to the end zone. Intercepted! Two times tonight he's been intercepted in the end zone, and it's Sky Moore again! Sky Moore! Sky high in Charlotte!
This South Carolina defense has made so many big plays in critical down and distances, red zone, fourth down. This time they show blitz at the snap, drop out of it. They're able to flush Marquise Williams outside the pocket, and the Cardinals sin as a quarterback, rolling to your right, throwing back across your body. And there's the ball hawk middle linebacker.
Sky Moore has been Marquise Williams' best red zone threat this game.
Unfortunately for Tar Heels fans.
But guys, and I don't like the decision to go for it on fourth down. You kick a field goal, it's a gimme field goal, your defense is playing lights out, you've got two timeouts in your back pocket, you can get the football back, your field goal kicker's been playing great, he's hit two long field goals in this game. I just didn't like the decision by Larry Fedora. Easy to say now, but fourth and goal from the 8, that's not easy to convert.
Going to be a timeout used here, as South Carolina was very confused with the personnel they wanted on the field after the interception. It was a fourth and goal from the 8-yard line, and that costly decision by Williams two times. By Sky Moore here in this game.
No, he's been interception. And you got to give the defense for South Carolina credit because they're the ones making the plays in those situations. But kick a field goal, make it a one-point game. Defense is playing well. Count on them getting it back. Now you've got two timeouts in your back pocket with a field goal kicker that's been hot. You need a field goal to win and walk out of here. I don't love it.
I'm all for crediting players, but that's horrible by Marquise Williams. I mean, you have to throw it to your guy so he can try to make a play. It's fourth down, so it's got to get near your receiver so he at least has a chance. I don't care if you throw a pick, but you can't throw a pick right to a defensive guy and not even give your offensive guy a chance to make a play.
Now they run Farrell Cooper on a lead there. As you can see, the disappointment in the face of Marquise Williams. Remember, he's from right here in Charlotte, was a star at Mallard Creek High. This meant a lot to him. Those three interceptions, costly one came, which is 3:40 to play. Will he get another chance? Now we all have our weekend duties coming up. Davey, you're going to be heading to Fort Worth for College Game Day built by the Home Depot. Looking forward to hearing what you got to say. Reese, Herbie, Dez, David, and Coach Corso, College Game Day from Fort Worth, 9 a.m. Jess, you're going to see Coach Mack make his debut down in Gainesville.
Yeah, I get to go down there and sweat some more in Gainesville. It'll be great.
A little bit of humidity there. Good, strong run from Brandon Wiles.
That was huge, obviously, for South Carolina. The clock now has to be their friend. Lead this thing. If I'm Steve Spurrier, I'm G.A. Magnus, the quarterback coach, I'm reminding Connor Mitch, hey, man, let this thing go down to as close to zero as you can before snapping.
He's let it go down below zero a couple times,
yeah,
so don't
exactly.
do that, though.
So remind him.
North Carolina only has that one remaining timeout as that clock is counting down now under 2 minutes and 50 seconds to play. So we've got to think about managing the timeout. Downs here with South Carolina looking to put this thing away. As Wiles surges ahead to the 36-yard line.
Another reminder is ball security for these running backs. Two hands on the football. Don't try and fight and stretch for that extra yard if you don't need to.
North Carolina will use their last timeout here.
You got to think at this time now, you know, one more first down by South Carolina. Let's get the victory formation ready.
It's hard to imagine that guy right there, Elijah Hood. I think he had 12 carries tonight. For
12 for 138, David.
So why does he have 12 carries? Man, I think North Carolina fans probably like to see a few more of those, especially in that red zone area where they threw a couple interceptions tonight.
Now keep in mind how much, you know, we've been talking about it all week long leading up to tonight, how much talent is on this North Carolina offense. You look at the receiving core and you see what Hood's capable of. Now Williams is throwing the turnovers, but South Carolina's shut them out here in the second half, and now their offense can try to seal it. Connor Mitch back in. Remember, the left hip was a concern earlier in this second half. Another handoff to Brandon Wiles, and Wiles will be close to that line to make as a roar comes from the Gamecocks fans who've made the shorter drive here to Charlotte.
Now, this is such a big game for South Carolina because they don't have any easy opponents early this year for a young, inexperienced offense and a new system on defense to score a bunch of points, have success, and build confidence. You're going to go play Kentucky at home next week, who beat you last year. Then you go at number 9, Georgia. Good UCF team comes to town. Two-time defending SEC East champ on the road in Missouri. And then you get LSU. So, you know, if South Carolina walks out of here with a win, that is huge for their conference, which they need badly to start this season.
Wiles was marked short, so this is 3rd and 1, and then he takes care of it, picking up the first down on that run. Big weekend of college football that is topped off Monday night and then capped by SVP, who's taken his talents to midnight. So after Ohio State, Virginia Tech, you're going to see a whole new look of SportsCenter. It is Scott Van Pelt's SportsCenter show. Little SVP SC. It's going to be weeknights at midnight on ESPN. Scott makes the debut of that show after Ohio State, Virginia Tech. Scotty, we wish you the best with that. I think it's going to be a lot of fun to see SVP take the reins of SportsCenter for his hour at midnight. How about Sky Moore? I mean, this is a guy who's been a tackling machine the last couple years, top 10 in the SEC. But it was the hands tonight.
Yes.
Two interceptions in the end
Guys,
zone.
Guys, what about just the defense in general for
Absolutely.
South Carolina? Both these teams, really, but you shut out North Carolina the entire second half, and you had 4 sacks, by the way. We saw a pass rush again. Give John Hoke, their new defensive coordinator, a lot of credit.
No, 14 all last season for this defense. Opening game against A&M, everybody saw how much they struggled, but you're right. And this isn't a bad offense. This is a really good offense. This offense is going to average well over 30 points a game, and they forced Marquise Williams into some tough plays and made him make a couple mistakes and took advantage of it. Don't be stupid and get suspended for a game by doing something at the end of the game.
Coaches are going to make sure that this thing ends peacefully. By the way, Steve Spurrier now 6-0 against North Carolina. And for South Carolina, their 20th win in their last 21 non-conference games. Sky Moore, 2 interceptions in the end zone. South Carolina 17-13. It was a great night here in Charlotte, but it's only the beginning. We got TCU in action, and their Heisman hopeful against Minnesota. Pash, Greasy, and Tommy Lewis with the call. Enjoy the rest of your night.